Post-consumer recycling. It's a fancy expression for the materials that the general public separates from its garbage and puts into the recycling stream. Connecting Point's Brian Sullivan visited the Springfield Materials Recycling Facility, affectionately referred to as the Murph, to learn all about post-consumer single stream, dual stream, and the business of recycling.
Here in my apartment, this is my version of dual stream recycling. Paper and cardboard in this box, everything else in these other two. That includes plastic, metal, and glass. It doesn't seem that long ago that we had multi-stream recycling, where metal had its own bin, glass was separated by color, and plastic by number. Even paper-based products had separate bins. My trips to the dump usually included several boxes and bags, which may have seemed excessive, but it was at least organized.
Now it all goes into just two bags. This one for paper, this one, everything else. And depending on who provides the pickup service, all that separation work I did in my kitchen could be negated if it ends up going to a single stream facility.
So instead of putting all of that hard work to waste, we headed to one of the last few dual stream operations around on Burney Ave in Springfield. This place is known as the MRF, or Materials Recycling Facility, which houses paper processing on one side and plastic, metal, and glass on the other.
We have two different processes. One just for commingle, so when the trucks come in, they just have bottles and cans. And then we have another truck that will come in, they'll bring in just the fiber, the paper, the newspaper, OCC, which is cardboard. And single stream, everything goes in the same bucket. So everything goes in the container, the truck comes up, and they take everything all at once, and it goes to a facility that will process everything.
Even though dual stream recycling is really just one step above single stream, it is still better. On the fiber side of the building, we see fewer contaminants in the stream as a result, but there's still a need for source separation and quality control. Cardboard makes its way from the hopper up this conveyor belt to this one here. And thanks to some help from the Lubo system and some keen eyes and quick hands, a majority of what makes it through here is cardboard only. Over here is all other paper, with more eyes and hands to guarantee a clean product, which when all is said and done, looks like this. With more recyclable materials flowing through the stream on the other side of the house, the process becomes a little more involved.
On our commingle side, it goes up at a conveyor belt, and it goes into, in the first part of the system, it'll pull any of the metals off the first conveyor belt. Then it goes into a sort room where we have sorters, and we're actually hand sorting a lot of these products.
While the sorting room may be considered the central artery of the commingle side of operations, the MRF in its entirety takes in roughly 2,000 tons of material per month. The over 70 contributing communities run all the way from Adams to Westfield and all Western Mass points in between. It's one of the positive aspects of single and dual stream recycling. More people contributing means more recyclable materials in the stream. Ideally, that's good business for plants like this one, because once everything is sorted, it gets processed and cubed into these bales, which are then sold and traded on the open market, just like any other commodity, depending on its demand.
We sell that as a commodity. It could be steel, could be aluminum, and it could be HDPE, natural, those types. So we'll separate them all, and then we'll sell them as commodities.
The prices on those commodities have seen a downturn in recent years, plastics in particular. In general, post-consumer plastics already have a low recapture rate, which, depending on the type, can be anywhere between 9% and 30%. This means a majority of it ends up in our landfills or elsewhere and not being recirculated. Now, with stricter regulations being enforced by foreign markets to which the materials are normally sent, commodities like plastics are at a bit of a standstill. This is due partly to market saturation, but it's also a negative reflection on single and dual stream recycling. With a wider base of recyclers, we're now seeing a higher rate of contaminants and actual garbage entering the stream. And as a throwaway society, many are skipping right past the reduce and reuse steps and going straight to the recycling end, which, for the most part, is just as easy as throwing things away. The problem is, garbage doesn't cut it here at the MRF or any recycling center.
We have the right to reject a load if they're bringing in a lot of stuff that, you know, things that we don't want to see in a recycling plant is trash. So if any kind of trash comes in there, that's a do not in our facility.